Now, what we were preparing to find was the voltage on the line at its center point as a function of time. Again, this is like putting an oscilloscope on the center of the line and seeing what we can see as a function of time. The way we calculate this, or the way we observe it from the bounce diagram, is to draw a dashed line at the location that we are interested in. This is the center of the line. What we can see is that along the center, there's zero voltage until V1 plus gets there. So I'm going to draw a dashed line from this junction right here out to the plot that I'm preparing. So I'm going to have zero voltage right there until I come to the point where I get V1 plus. And my voltage is going to step up to V1 plus. Let's go back to see what V1 plus is. Right here, V1 plus, we can see, is 1/3 volt. So my voltage is going to step up to V1 plus, which is equal to 1/3 volt. And it's going to stay exactly that same way until V1 minus comes. And at that point, the voltage is going to change to V1 plus plus V1 minus. Let's go back and see what V1 minus was. V1 minus is 1/9. Is that right? I think I've got a minus sign here. I think it's supposed to be minus 1/9. So V1 minus is minus 1/9, which means I'm going to step down just a little bit. This is going to be 1/3 minus 1/9. That's the magnitude that I'll see right here. And it's going to stay that way until V2 plus comes along. And then it's going to step to V1 plus plus V1 minus plus V2 plus. Let's go see what V2 plus is. V2 plus is minus 1/27 of a volt. So I'm going to have 1/3 minus 1/9 minus 1/27, which means it's going to step down just a little bit more. And again, it's going to stay that way until V2 plus comes, at which time it will go to V1 plus plus V1 minus plus V2 plus plus V2 minus. Let's go see what V2 minus is. V2 minus is plus 1/3. Oops, let's go back here. So this is going to be 1/3 minus 1/9 minus 1/27 plus 1/3. So it's going to step up just a little bit. There are a few interesting things to notice here. One of them is that the voltage may step up or down depending on the reflection coefficient that I had at the generator and at the load. The other thing is that each of these steps, this step right here, this step right there, this little step right here, all of the steps reduce with time, which means the amount of change that I see gets smaller and smaller and smaller. The value that this eventually goes to when time equals infinity is called V infinity, and that is Vg times Zl over Zl plus Rg. So what we've done in this example is we have looked for the voltage at the center of the line as a function of time. The way we did that is we put a dashed line down through the point that we were interested in, the center of the line, and every place that we intersected our bounce diagram, I drew a dashed line across, representing a change in voltage that we would expect. I then considered each change caused by the line that was reaching my point at exactly that time. So first I added V1 plus, then I added V1 minus, then V2 plus, and then V2 minus, and allowed my voltages to step up or step down according to the sum of the two. Now if I really needed to, I could turn this around so that I could look at it with time along my bottom oscilloscope axis, and I could look at V at L over 2. But frankly, I'm just as good at looking at this from top to bottom, so if you want to leave it that way on your exam, you're welcome to. If you want to see it the other way around, just turn your paper.